The congregation, please be seated.
Believe in God, believe also in me. For in my Father's house are many mansions.
If it were not so, would I have told you that I go and prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you to myself. The words of the Apostle Paul to the Romans. For I am sure that neither death nor life, nor angels nor principalities, nor things at present nor things to come, nor powers nor height, nor depth, nor anything else in all of creation will be able to separate us from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus, our Lord. For none of us live to himself. None of us die to himself. For if we live, we live to the Lord. And if we die, we die to the Lord. So then, whether we live or whether we die, we are the Lord's. For to this end, Christ died and lived again. He might be both the Lord of the dead and of the living. The words of the Apostle Peter. Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. For by his great mercy we have been born anew to a living hope, through the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead, to an inheritance which is imperishable, undefiled, and unfading, kept in heaven for you. We unite our hearts together in the fellowship of prayer. Let us pray. Almighty God, our heavenly Father and Lord, as we, your children, gather together today in this place, O Lord, to celebrate the life, O Lord, that you have given to Sylvia Paul, together with her family and friends, O Lord. And, O Lord, the saints that have gone on before, the great crowd of witnesses that we are surrounded by, Father, we confess that you are God of love. You are God whose love is everlasting. And Lord, that love can turn the shadow of death into the light of a new day. So we, your children, pray now, O God, in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, and with the presence of your Holy Spirit with us now, dear Lord, we ask, Heavenly Father, to help us now as we wait upon you with penitent and believing hearts, that as we hear the words of eternal life, Lord, through your love and through your glory, we will continue to have hope. For your Son Jesus is the hope of earth and he is the joy of heaven. And that we will be lifted up above our present in darkness and distress into the light and peace and presence of you, O Lord. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior, we pray. Amen. A hymn from the program still.
Thank you.
suffering, and in times like these, a source of comfort, courage, patience, my friends. The first scripture lesson this evening is taken from Paul's letter to the Corinthians, 2 Corinthians chapter 4, verses 8 to 18. This is Gloria Paul with leaders in the community.
She believed in the justice of the Lord. 9/11 now has a new meaning for my family, more so than it had before. We have lost a most caring, unselfish, and generous in all the ways mother, a grandmother, a sister, an aunt, a cousin, a friend, a neighbor, a colleague, and lots of relations to other people. She always fought a good fight and held on to her faith, just like Job in the Bible when he faced adversity. A woman who, even though small in size, was big and strong, just like Walter Jericho. A woman who was not afraid to uproot her life from Venezuela and start back from zero because the needs of others came first. She was a person who would give her last of whatever she had, even though she needed it more. With a shrug of her shoulder, and she would say, "I could always get more. It had more seller." Why? Because to her, material things were just that, materials. It could always be replaced. Her passion was her son, her granddaughter, and her family, and doing good for others. While she was living in Venezuela, anytime someone from home visited, she would always send something for everyone so that no one would feel that they were forgotten or that she did not remember who they were. You know, it was like, carry this vitamin for Tita, eh? Because it's good for she bones. And you know, as she gets older, you're getting osteoporosis. And carry this drops of carrot so that she would put it in her water, you know. Tell she to put 7 drops in the water and make sure she stay it and drink it so she could get more oxygen in she blood. Or it was, and make sure they send this cooler bed and give it for Ursula. You know, when she reach home from work in the evening from the hospital, she could just be so tired, you know, and it just be so thin. So carry Nasa Randy, you know, he go rub she foot and, you know, she cool, she foot will feel cool and fresh. And the list goes on and on and on. You know, like she would say, "Oh, you know, I try like this perfume. Yeah, she like this, you know, you better carry it for she." And you know, when she came upon these things, she would start reminiscing, "You know, when I went back home the last time, Ivan tell me this, or Randy say that. You know, Simon used to always tell me this." She would always go back into reminiscing about the times with, you know, her siblings. Gustavo, her siblings, the adopted family in Venezuela and Canada, Auntie Pinky in Arizona, my kids, my brothers, my sisters, my cousins, my nieces, my nephews, my cousins near and far, her brother-in-law, sisters-in-law, my nephew, myself. We are all feeling this loss so much right now. But you know, she did tell Gustavo that. She always told Gustavo, "I was always the first to do lots of things in my family. I was the first one to go away. I was the first one to fly in a plane. I was the first one to migrate and live on the outside. And I will be the first to go. I will go and I will die and I will leave all of them." She kept her word. In so doing, so it was, so it said. Or in her words, as she would say, she was transformed. She was transforming for everybody else. She was the first grandmother to my kids and the first in teaching me a lot of life lessons. For that I am thankful. To the Mejias family abroad, she was a sister to them. They were a negrita, part and parcel of their family. Bao said that she was such a trustworthy person, that Bao could have never given her key to the cupboard to any one of her daughters, but she gave it to Auntie Mary. Because she didn't trust Maritza and Carmen and Violeta, and she said they would take their money, but Sylvia would keep it safe for her. So she gave Auntie Mary the key to her wardrobe. ¿Cómo le amaba la sopa de mondongo en casa de Bao los domingos? Sí, Gustavo. Y ella también le gustaba ir para Tinaquillo para comer cachapa, ¿sí? She really, really loved to go by Bao on a Sunday. And she loved to make and eat soup. She loved to partake of that. She would love to go to Tinaquillo on Sunday to eat the corn cakes that we call cachapas in Venezuela. It was a passion of hers. It is safe to say that my auntie was a woman who was loved internationally, is loved internationally. It would really be selfish on our part if we were to say that we wanted her to stay and continue in the condition that she was in. She knew what was coming. She tried to prepare us. Even in her last days, you know, she chose the one who she thought would be strong and would have to help and uphold the others. Even me, the last time that I saw her, she asked to see me, and she just told me that she wanted to tell me goodbye. She knew what was coming. I wasn't prepared for this. I was actually angry that she told me that that would be the last time that she would really talk to me. I was not prepared then, and I was not prepared to say no. She took pride in all of the family's accomplishments, all her nieces and nephews, her brothers and her sisters, no matter the circumstances. She was always proud of her family, very boastful, you know, about how bright and pretty and smart they were. She was never one to indulge in idle talk, but always found something good to say. She never had time to gossip, always forgiving and ever loving. Forgive us, dear, if in algún momento nosotros te hemos fallado. Lo lamentamos mucho, tía. She was always independent, strong-willed, and stubborn, but at the same time, working for everything that she earned and everything that she wanted, because she always believed in working to earn her keep. She didn't believe in depending on anybody, because as far as she was concerned, if she can earn it for herself, then she would have the satisfaction of saying, I did this by myself. I didn't have to depend on anyone or anybody for help. I was a big woman and I could do things for myself. Tia, we love you with our all and we know that you are in your glory where you wanted to be. Welcomed in the wide open arms of your mom, dad, and I'm sure Ba was there to receive you too. Váyanse tranquilo y en paz. Go without worries. Go in peace. We will take care of the rest. Que la paz te mora y la felicidad de nosotros, que nosotros te queríamos. Que el amor de mi abuela y que todos los demás te acompañen en su viaje, tía. Váyase con Dios, que nosotros también estaremos tranquilos y en paz contigo. Thank you.
Good evening, everyone. If I repeat some things from Alyssa, please excuse me. 69 years ago, the United States detonated the first hydrogen bomb, and young Elizabeth was crowned Queen of England. Meanwhile, in Trinidad, Queen Flory and King Andrew welcomed a new baby girl on May 23rd into their family as their fourth child of 10. They named her Sylvia, and she was the apple of her eyes because she looked so much like him. So she was his little mommy, mama, mommy, and so this word eventually evolved into Mammy, the name she was so lovingly known as. Ma always said that she was Pa's favorite, much to our chagrin, as she got on with it so much when she was around, when he was around. To us, the younger five, we call her Pepper Branch, as she was very authoritative and bossy towards us. But we know now that's how she cared for us. She always prided herself as one who blazed trails, and as Alicia was saying, being the first to accomplish many things, and of course the two that she touched, I am touching on. The first to fly on a plane and the first to fly away. Her educational background took her from Marist Anglican to Vista Bella CM, then to Progressive Institute. At Progressive Institute, she befriended a young Venezuelan student who was at the school to learn English. Of course, in those days, many young people from Venezuela used to come to Trinidad to learn English in some of our schools, in private schools especially.
This young woman, Carmen Gonzalez, eventually came to live at our home, and we became, instead of 10 kids, we became 11 kids. Instead of 5 girls, we became 6 girls. That was the beginning of the Venezuelan connection. When Carmen returned to Venezuela, many accompanied her on a short vacation, which extended and extended and extended into about 6 months. While there, she charmed the Gonzalez family and soon was the apple of Bao's and Abelito's eyes. That's Mr. and Mrs. Gonzalez. On her return to Trinidad, she worked for many years at Kirkland's until finally she migrated to Venezuela in around 1973 on the request of her new family. She lived and worked there for almost 43 years with her son and even acquired her very own house or home until her return in 2016, when she had that foresight that it was becoming a dire situation in Venezuela. Always being a very independent soul, she settled in Pinal with her son, Gustavo, and her beautiful little granddaughter, Ashley Samantha. As life would have it, ill health stepped in, and hence our reason for being here today in this church. For those of us who cared for her in her last days, we experienced a grace being at her bedside, praying and singing as she transitioned out of this world. There was this incredible sacredness in that room between 3:30 and 3:35 on 9/11. Her parting was so peaceful. What an incredible gift to Lilla Carol and I on that, at that, you know, that time. Even in her death, she was generous by giving us this gift of experiencing her transition. A sister, a mom, grandmother, aunt, cousin, and friend starts a new journey onto heaven without a body. I know we can never say goodbye to her soul, but today we are saying farewell to her body. In closing, on behalf of the family, I would like to express our sincere and immense gratitude to Clyde, Carol, Nikki, and Rod for having our sister at their home in her last days. I'd also like to take this opportunity also to thank the local board of the Pinal Presbyterian Church, or their organist, the chairperson, Maggie, for allowing us to have this funeral in this church. As we requested it, we got back word that it was. So thank you very much, local board. Rest in peace, sweet Sylvia. Safe in the arms of Jesus, safe on his gentle breast. There, by his love or shade, sweetly your soul shall rest. And we are all secured in the thought that our loss is her reunion. Thank you.
Thank you very much. And we also have our presence this evening, Gustavo, son of Sylvia. And we want to say a few words of Gustavo and the regular transition.
Hola, buenas tardes. Buenas tardes. Mi mamá era un ser único y especial, afianzada a su religión, pero sobre todo trabajadora, luchadora por lo que quería. Cuando estábamos en Venezuela, siempre recordaba sus tradiciones y especialmente a toda su familia. Nunca olvidó su tierra donde nació. Pero cuando nos mudamos desde Venezuela a vivir en Trinidad, ella se sintió muy triste. Extrañaba mucho a la tierra que la formó y en la cual emprendió esa misma tierra donde yo nací, Venezuela. Y desde ese momento siempre estuve a su lado Nadie se imagina que era el amor que ella sentía por esa tierra, que la refugió y en la que conoció a maravillosas personas que obviamente vieron su partida. Pero como dice el dicho, la sangre pesa más que el agua. Ella fue una gran persona. Ahora su cuerpo queda aquí en la tierra, natal junto a toda su familia. Gracias, mami, por tanto que me enseñaste todo, menos a vivir sin ti. Siento un poco de miedo de continuar sin ti. Tú fuiste mi guía, mi defensora, mi fuerza, todo. Ahora que no estás conmigo, le pido fuerza a Dios para seguir adelante. Por mi hija, que fue tu nieta y tanto que amabas. Sé que me diste una lección en tus últimos días y eso fue una de las más grandes lecciones de mi vida. El aprender a caminar solo. Mami, te amo, te llevaré siempre en mi corazón.
second scripture lesson. It is taken from the book of Job, chapter 19, verses 23 to 27. And Big Sister Maria Babla lead us in the reading.
Oh,
mental arts together in the church of prayer, the spirit. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, we praise you, God, for this time, for your word, O God, of wisdom, for your strength, O God, the praise, O Lord, of all our siblings, nephews and nieces, and colleagues in ministry, and all the Lord who lift us this day through your word and through their prayers. That we, O Lord, now, dear Father, we can better say, oh, how we trust in Jesus. How we trust in the Holy Lamb of God, the Son of God. We ask now, God, that you will speak to us. Bring our hearts closer to you, O Lord, in this time. For the words of my mouth, the meditation of all our hearts, be acceptable in our sight, O God, our strength and our Redeemer. Amen. As little children, we loved in the Lord, growing up in this and part of the work, our busy with the cooking and the cleaning and the washing, steward and Maria off to school at Marbella Boys and Girls East respectively, that left Mary and myself at home. And we would often, as little children, go to the garden among the seniors and among the lady slippers and the game girls, for what we know today as marigold, and we would catch the butterflies. But as we approached the butterflies were fly away from us. And so we devised a way to catch the butterfly. We took one of God's old orange and we would bring it and cast it over them and then catch the butterfly. What happened, my dear friends, when we play with them sometimes, the butterflies die. And so we desist from doing that. And we didn't know, my dear friends, about the paradoxical saying that if you will sit gently, that elusive butterfly might come and alight on your shoulder. So often, my dear friends, in our adult lives, we wait, we do things, and we wait for the elusive butterfly to alight upon our soul. Somehow, my dear friend, somebody with crooked intentions would come and rather allow the butterfly to alight on our shoulder, we would chase them away. And so, this is life. You have heard, my dear friends, from the reflection much about sin death love. You have heard from the teacher of the song, the precious memories. But what about all of us in our own life? When we see things happen around us by dear friends, by people who are crooked, and we remember, my friends, the words of the prophet Amos, standing by a wall and seeing God with a plumb line in his hand. And asks, Lord, why are you holding that plumb line? And you know, my dear friends, God was trying to get the message across, because I want people to be straight. In your lifetime, my dear friends, and in our own lifetime, we would have been disappointed with some of the things. And we say we are afflicted. But we're reminded by the Apostle Paul, even though we are afflicted, we're not crushed. Even though we were perplexed about the things in life, we were not driven to despair. For we always have Jesus, the Son of God, who is the hope of earth and the joy of heaven. We're not destroyed.
today, my dear friends, the family we have talked about, you know, are still getting regenerated. The things that you are disappointed about, you know, the fact that you had a home in Venezuela, and then forgiveness came, my dear friends, but not at her own beckon. She had to leave the home that she built to come back here. You might say it is because she in Cascadura, and not because of that, my dear friends. The flight and many of the lives of the nationals of Venezuela had to be stopped. Because, my dear friends, it was perilous time in their life. The home that she built couldn't stay there. Vandalized her property. Pilfered. The money that she saved for the sums of money that she could have gotten from a company. Not to be coming. And she came here, my dear friends, back to Trinidad, started over two humble doings, two humble accomplishments. One time, Patricia Lane and Salutary for their assistance, and as Margarita said, for Klein and Carol and their children, who afforded us place and time so we can have it now. Comfortable care. Sometimes I listen, my dear friends, to some of the announcements in the COVID-19 broadcasts and things like that. And I hear doctors speaking about that, you know, a bed is not a bed in the hospital without doctors and nurses and all that. And I wonder how come the bed that she was afforded at the hospital did not give her that type of care that she should have gotten. Maybe it was too far gone. But why was she allowed to degenerate, my dear friends, into the vegetable that she ended up on? When I say that, my dear friends, I don't mean anything, you know, bad about my sister. We know her speaking and singing. And for she not to have a voice and to speak to us in the things that happened to her, the sword that came upon her body because somebody didn't take care of her. But thank God, her sisters, sister-in-law, nieces, nephews, brothers, and all. And all my dear friends who rose to the occasion and to the young doctors who gave their time came to puff up face to assist. I ask again, are we crushed? No. Because Jesus, the Son of God, is our hope of hope and joy of heaven. And the Apostle Paul reminds us, my dear friends, but even though this earthly body is wasting away, the inner body is being renewed every day and being prepared for glory. And so was it with her. Because you see, sometimes we look at the things, let us see, but they are transient. But the things that are not seen, the glory that we would receive from the hand of a loving Savior, my dear friend. As someone said, no more sickness, no more pain, for the former things have passed away. I would like to remind us of the hymn of Timothy Reeves in our songbook, 313. When human hearts are breaking on the sorrow iron rod, all the aching and all the pain ring with pain, the heart of God. We want you to know this evening, my dear. dear friends and the families, the brothers and sisters and the nephews and nieces of Sylvia. Yes, my dear friends, we know. Even though our hearts are breaking, God, heart is bringing the pain with all of us, and we give him all the honor and glory. And then someone might ask, why did she go? How come? How come she degenerated so quickly? How come she died? She was just a poor child. How come? It was the same thing, my dear friends, that was said to Job by his friends, Bildad, Zophar, and Eliphaz. Job, what you did? What did you do? How come you are receiving adversity instead of prosperity? All I did was to trust God, he says. And he says, behold, I know my Redeemer lives. I know my Redeemer lives. You know what you can do? You can write down about my life. Write it down, carve it in stone. Use an iron pen. So it will be there for all time. And I think this evening, my dear friends, the words of our sister Nathan and Gustavo, you know, they were inscribing our hearts to know something about Sylvia. Yes, she knows that her Redeemer lived. And in the time she will see God and not another. Not another. Because she trusted her Lord. She trusted the Lord. She yielded herself to his tender embrace, my dear friend. And she heard the voice of the wisdom God saying, come home to me. He who already come home, as the songwriter would have said, and of God, who will receive her into his loving bosom, safe in the arms of Jesus. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, we unite our hearts together in the fellowship of prayer. Let us pray. Almighty God and Heavenly Father, we thank you now, O God, Lord, for the life of our beloved Sylvia. As she goes, O Lord, Father, to join the great crowd of witnesses that we are surrounded by, we thank you, dear God, for all that you are able, O Lord, to achieve through her lifetime here upon this earth. And for the inheritance that you have provided for us, which is imperishable, undefiled, and unfading, we thank you now, O God, that you have entered into the joy of your rest. Merciful God, the consolation of the sorrowful and the support of the weary, look down now, Lord, dear Father, upon the children whose joy has been turned into mourning. We ask, O Lord, dear Father, that you would bless her son Gustavo and her grandchild of God, the Samantha. The siblings, O God, Stevenson, Manalina, myself, David, Margaret, Carolyn, Randall, Simon, and Angeline, and all the various nephews and nieces, members of our in-laws, and cousins of the Lord, both Paul and Ishmael family, and her friends and relatives in Venezuela, especially your God, Ritzel, Amen. We ask now, O God, that as we commit her into your care, into your keeping, Lord, that we who are left here, Lord, will receive, O God, your grace and your strength. We love us, O Lord, again with your love. We will hold, O Lord, fast to thee, for you can bring life out of death. You can turn, O God, our grief into eternal joy. We pray in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, who has taught us to pray together as we say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as
all the way to the city.
everybody here? Yeah? Did he bring everybody here? Or what was it?
Huh? Okay, I'm not sure.
Please. Come, Carol.
Who is she coming right after the supermarket? Yeah.
Grandma,
yeah, I had a big one.
Oh my God! Thank you.
As you see, grass is under any bush.
I have experience falling in the cemetery. Come in now, go in front of me.
Anybody
else been up here?
I'm
all
one. Thank you. Thank you.
Everybody
keeps saying that.
Vámonos, mi gente.
Rosa,
encontré
en el camino.
No, si está desnuda. No lo sé.
Hey, I fall on inside over this and I go down in that cave.
Yes, I'm
going
to then boy will
guide
on the one
to
reach up there.
Yeah, it's there.
Everybody good?
Yeah.
We made it.
Shit.
Watch when all come in, watch all the foot on here.
Okay.
Watch all yourself. Right, watch, come in here, watch. Let's see my foot right there.
Okay.
Yeah, now hold it.
Yeah. Right, watch all yourself, right there.
Wait. Yeah, well,
seeing it?
No, just now. Okay.
Easy.
One, two, three. Okay, go. Take it. Be careful over here.
Yeah, watch all yourself, watch all yourself.
Yeah, I will help you.
Yeah. Just watch all the foot in here.
But big man.
Hey,
push it here. Is it my dad?
Humble, everything.
What's come on.
Better man go to
Better
man here, you.
You go home.
Excuse me. Thank you.
Let's take a cross, meanwhile.
Final viewing, please, quick.
Hello, Carol.
Let's wait, Eva.
You all wanted to see it? Go ahead,
ma'am. While they're taking the final view, we sing the
roses.
Yeah, the roses, please.
We have some flowers.
We have some flowers to put inside.
You have a flower tribute to me?
Yeah. Everybody can put the flowers in. Marie, bring the flowers.
Yeah.
Bring the roses.
I'm
just going to put them here for the last time.
Yeah. Make your flowers tribute, please. I mean, you can put the flowers, the individual flowers to put inside. While we sing, sing the wondrous love of Jesus. Praise God. Where are your copies, everybody? Sing the wondrous love of Jesus. Sing His mercy and His grace. In ever mansion, bright and blessed. He prepared for us a place, when we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that could be, when we all see Jesus, we will sing and we shout for victory. Onward to the prize before us, through the hills of beauty we'll be moved. Through the pearly gates we'll open, we shall tread the streets of glory. When we all get together, what a day of rejoicing that will be. When we all see Jesus, we will sing and shout for victory. Everybody have their final view? God is our refuge and our strength, a very present help in trouble. Therefore, we will not fear. Thanks be to God who gives us the victory through our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Therefore, my beloved brothers and sisters, be steadfast, immovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord. For in the Lord we know that your labor is not in vain. I am the resurrection and the life, saith the Lord. He who lives and believes in me, though he die, yet shall he live. And he who lives and believeth in me shall never die. As his Father pitieth his children, so the Lord pitieth those who fear him. For he knows our frame, he remembereth that we are dust. As for man, his days are like grass, he flourishes like a flower of the field. For the wind passes over it, and it is gone, and its place knows it no more. But the steadfast love of the Lord is from everlasting to everlasting upon those who fear him, and his righteousness to children and children. Hear not, I am the first and the last, the living one. I died, and behold, I am alive forevermore, and I have the keys of death and Hades. Behold, they shall hunger no more, neither shall they thirst any more. The sun shall not strike them, nor any scorching heat. For the Lamb is in the midst of the throne. He will be their shepherd, and he will guide them to springs of living water. And God will wipe away every tear from every eye. Amen. All the flowers should be been made already. Who had to put flowers could put the flowers, because we're going to close our box now. Everybody finished the last meal?
One second, Shastri.
Thank you.
Yeah, que sea fuerte para ti.
Sister here departed, we therefore commit her body to the ground, earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust. Trusting in God's great mercy by which we have been born anew through a living hope to the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead. I hear a voice from heaven saying, blessed are the dead who die in the Lord. Henceforth blessed indeed, say the Spirit, that they may rest from their labor, for their deeds follow them. O God, whose days are without end, and whose mercies cannot be numbered, make us deeply sensitive to the shortness and uncertainty of human life, and that led by your Holy Spirit through this present world, in holiness and righteousness all the days of our life, who have served thee in all day and all time, and all generations may be received by thee, O Heavenly Father, having the testimony of your good conscience, in communion of your church, in confidence of your faith, and in comfort and holy hope, and in faith of thee, O God and O Lord, and in perfect charity, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. We sing a hymn for the music. Then we all in the street by and by.
There's a land of fairer than day, and by faith we can see it afar. For the Father waits over the way to prepare us a dwelling place there. In the sweet beautiful shore in the sweet by and by. We shall meet on that beautiful shore.
We shall sing on the beautiful shore.
The melodious sounds of the blessed, and your spirit shall sorrow no more. For the blessing of grace in the sweet by and by, we shall meet on that beautiful shore in the sweet by and by. We shall meet on that beautiful shore in the beautiful Father above. We will offer a tribute of praise for the glorious gift of his love. And Trumpet of the Lord shall sound, and time shall be no more, and the morning breaks eternal, bright and fair. When the saved of earth shall gather over on the other shore, and the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. When the roll is called up yonder, when the for the Master from the dawn till setting sun, let us soak up all his wondrous love and care. And when all of life is over and our work on earth is done, and the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. When the roll is called up yonder, when the roll
bright and cloudless morning, when the dead in Christ shall rise, and the glory of his resurrection share. When his chosen one shall gather to their home beyond the sky, and the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. When the roll is called up yonder, when the roll my God, while I in awesome wonder consider all the world thy hands have made, I see the stars, I hear the rolling thunder, thy thought throughout the universe displays, and sings my soul. Oh.
I shall fill my heart. Then I shall bow in humble adoration and there proclaim, my God, how great thou art. Then sings my soul.
May the God of peace, who brought again from the dead our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, the great shepherd of the sheep, by the blood of the everlasting covenant, equip you with everything that is good, that you may do the will of the Lord, working in you that which is pleasing in the sight of God. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior, to whom be glory forever and ever. Amen. Someday, I'll go where Jesus is. Someday, I'll go where Jesus is. Someday, I'll go where Jesus is. And I'll be caught up to meet him. Caught up to meet him, caught up to meet him in the air. And I'll be caught up to meet him, caught up to meet him. Joy and happiness, peace of mind. Someday in glory, I'll tell the story. Caught up to meet him in the air. And I'll be caught up to meet him, caught up to meet him. Joy and happiness, peace and mind. Someday in glory, I'll tell the story. Caught up to meet him in the air. Sign my name with a golden pen, a golden pen, a golden pen. Sign my name with a golden pen, sign my name up there. Sign my name, sign my name up there. Sign my name, sign my name up there. So sign my name with a golden pen, golden pen, a golden pen. Sign my name with a golden pen. Sign my name up there. Sign my name. Sign my name up there. Sign my name. Sign my name up there. So sign my name with a golden pen, a golden pen, a golden pen. Sign my name with a golden pen. Sign my name up there.
He that believeth, he that believeth, have an everlasting life. He that believeth on the Father and the Son, have an everlasting life. And when I get to heaven, walk all around, have an everlasting life. I will sit by my Savior, put on my crown, have an everlasting life.